twice.
Now we're starting.
Yay! All right, goats. All right, Iron Will Smith.
That's me. I'm ready. Are you ready?
Are you, all of you, ready to have some fun?
Yeah.
Are you ready to stand up for yourself?
Yeah. Are you ready to be assertive?
Yeah.
Then you're in luck. Brass Knuckles is my name.
And Iron Will Smith is mine.
And Training Ponies is our game. We welcome you to the first day of
your new life.
I want to hear you stomp if you're tired of being a pushover.
Stomp if you're tired of being a doormat.
Stomp if you want to pay nothing for this seminar. Woo! That's no joke, friends. Brass Knuckles is so confident that you will be 100% satisfied with Brass Knuckles' assertiveness skills that if you are not 100% satisfied,
you pay nothing!
If you knew that you could be confident, what would you do differently?
Totally doable.
You can. You can do anything. And today we'll prove to you that every brony can be assertive. And that includes you. But I pity the foal who doubts Brass Knuckles' methods. You don't doubt me, do you?
No.
No? That brings us to our first lesson. Don't be shy.
Look him in the eye.
Yeah. Before we get started, I'm going to share some assertiveness rules with you all. I want you all to know that while Iron Will Smith and myself, Brass Knuckles, are here to make you a better you, we're not trained professionals. If you need help, don't be afraid to seek it from the pros. I'm actually training to become a coach, and I will be able to help more in the future, but for now, please find professionals if you need that help. Second, we will have participation, right, Iron Will Smith?
Yeah, it's gonna get fun.
It's gonna get fun. So even if you're sitting in the back, watch out. We're going to make sure that we have volunteers, but it'll be fun. And this is a safe environment because we're all bronies here. And it's the most encouraging place that you can find to be able to face your fear and get up on stage. We'll cheer you on.
And remember, if anybody laughs, it's probably because I'm just really funny. They're not laughing at you. Don't worry about it.
We're not trying to tease or make fun of any pony. And to prove that, goats, let's call up our first volunteer. We would like to find a Fluttershy in the audience. I see a couple. And they tend to look very shy. No, not that one. That goat's a little attached to the Fluttershy.
Part of the panel is being okay with yourself.
Right?
Like I said.
Be confident. I think I see one over here, goats, up front.
Hey, guys.
Oh, in the back?
Oh, well, there's a few, actually.
In the very back. Let's hear it for our first volunteer.
Iron Will wants you on stage.
And everybody that's coming in, settle down. One of the rules is don't be a square. Use the stairs. That's right.
We don't got no squares in our circle.
Yeah. Everybody, let's welcome Fluttershy. And Fluttershy, what's your name?
My name's Jillian.
Oh, Jillian.
Everyone, this is Jillian. Now, I'm hoping you saw putting your hoof down about my colleague, Iron Will Smith. What did Fluttershy teach Iron Will Smith?
I haven't taught anything yet.
So, in the episode, Fluttershy taught Iron Will Smith an important lesson. It started with N-O.
No means no.
Ah.
We're prepared.
Do you all remember that? No means no. Right there. And all volunteers get a snazzy keychain, so thank you so much.
So if you like free stuff, raise your hand.
And we can escort Fluttershy back down the stairs. Thank you so much for volunteering.
An important part of that is that no means no was a tough lesson to learn, but it's really true.
Whether it's here at our seminar, at BronyCon, or in the real world, no means no always applies. You have to respect somepony if they don't want to do something, so please don't pressure them.
And because no means no, if we call you up, you have the right to refuse.
That's right. It's definitely important. And consider volunteering. We had a great volunteer come up, and it wasn't too difficult, right? Oh, good. Again, this is the safest, most encouraging place that you will find to practice being assertive, and we are here to help. Which brings us to our third rule. We are all friends here, and we're all here because we're at BronyCon. So we want to have fun in the name of friendship. There's no teasing in this seminar, no name calling, and no bullying.
Don't you mean bullying? That's a joke, ladies and gentlemen. Get ready for about 300 of those.
Yes. Oh, Iron Will Smith. We need to respect every pony. Crowd, do you understand? Yes. I can't hear you.
That's it. That's right.
Yeah. Now to demonstrate that my techniques will work for any pony, let's call up our next volunteer. Yeah, in the middle. Brass Knuckles wants you on stage. Let's hear it. So go. Can your mic make it? Yeah, go for it.
Oops. Ooh. Oh no.
My tail. We're all good.
I got it.
We're all good.
I got it.
I think that was a fail with Brass Knuckles' tail.
Wouldn't be the first time tail's gotten anybody in trouble.
I'm Will Smith. I told you not to tell them.
I kid.
Oh. So, volunteer, what's your name?
Maddie.
Everyone, this is Maddie.
Hi,
Maddie. Maddie, I want you to come over here and join me, but Iron Will Smith, ooh, what's he doing? Come on, come on, over here.
Excuse me, please.
Ooh, right? When some pony tries to block,
show them that you rock!
That's right. Don't be sorry, be assertive. You did a great job. What do you guys think? Such a great job that you also get a fantastic keychain and you can take the other stairs down.
She bought her own mic. She was prepared.
I know. Let's hear it again for Maddie. You see, my friends, if my techniques can work for these shy little ponies, then they can work for any pony! Now, I have something I'd like you all to do. Because every brony can be assertive, I want you to turn to some pony next to you, say, I can be assertive, and hoof bump. I can be assertive.
Can be, and I will be.
Yeah! All right. How do you feel? Is that good?
Yeah.
So now that we've started with a bang, I would like to formally welcome you to Brass Knuckles Assertiveness Seminar. Today, you'll learn what assertiveness is and also how to use even more assertiveness skills. But before that, some introductions are in order. Let me present to you my assistants.
Hi. They call me Iron Will Smith because I tend to look like him sometimes on a good day. But my real name is Royce. I'm 19 years old, and I'm here for the same reason that you guys are. I like Technicolor cartoon horses.
Yeah! Woo! My counterpart in compassion. What a fantastic guy. I also have two goat assistants, Hanky and Panky.
There's a reason we call them that.
So from now on, they'll be down pacing the aisles, looking for volunteers, and also keeping an eye out for troublemakers that are playing too much Pokemon Go.
We have eyes.
Remember, don't be shy.
Look them in the eye.
That's right. So what do you think about our goats? Let's hear it. Thank you all for making it out this afternoon. It's a wonderful day here at BronyCon, and I know that you all have your heads on straight. So,
who's at BronyCon for the first time?
Wow!
You guys came here for real?
Woo-hoo! Thank you! Great!
You guys have good judgment.
That is fantastic.
How about 2 years?
Two. Okay.
How about 3 years? Do I hear three?
Kay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
How about 5 years?
For BronyCon.
I know.
We got a lot of hands up still.
We still got it. Four though. Four. Is it any? Okay. So I. Okay.
Five.
4 years,
okay. Six. Do we hear six?
Oh, six. Six. Has it been six?
Not officially. So again, all that have made it to all five BronyCons, because the hashtag is BronyCon 5, right? Raise your hands again. Five BronyCons.
5 years.
All five. All right. Round of applause.
Good on you guys.
Now for the important one. Who's here from another country? Oh, very
good. Woo! International.
Thank you for coming so far just to see us in person. Goats, why don't you give our foreign visitors some stickers? All right, and do we have children in the audience? Younger than 10, please. And not pony ears, actual ears.
If because we're all children at heart.
Raise your hands and the goats will give them stickers too. All right.
Oh, neat.
Remember, every brony can be assertive. We only have less than 40 minutes to show you how. And if you want to learn more, our assistants will also pass around a clipboard. On that clipboard, you can sign up for monthly emails from Brass Knuckles, in which you can learn more and sign up for my mailing list. Also, hashtag BrassKnucklesMLP, Riftwing Designs, and I have a Tumblr. So if you would like, please sign up the mailing list. Again, I said I will become a coach. I will help you. There is a place for your state, because I go to other conventions, and we would love to be able to talk to you there as well. So, we've talked about the basics, but we want to make other people jealous that they're not right here right now, right? And one way to do that is through social media. So what we're going to do right now is do a couple nice photo ops for you, a couple good poses, and then we're going to take a selfie with the audience. So if you want to be in it, move towards the middle, and if not, hashtag BrassKnucklesMLP. Let's show them that we rock. Iron Will Smith, are you ready?
Oh, I was born ready.
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. Man, it's like a showdown. It went back to back. I like this one. Yeah. How long can we stand like this, Iron Will Smith?
Hey, hold on.
Ooh, hey, goats. Yeah. Oh. Hmm. Yeah. Show them that you rock. Woo! Okay, now we're going to do our selfie. So everybody make your pretty pony faces.
Anybody have a selfie stick?
No, we're not doing that. It took too long. And anyways, I don't want them staring at my plot for a minute. Okay, everybody come on in. Everybody in the back, say hi. One, two, three.
Yeah.
One more from up high. Woo! All right, we got them! Woo! So I'm gonna post that really quick to my Tumblr and you guys can catch a Pokemon while I'm going. Let's see, this one looks good. Post it on everything. Bang! There it is. At Riftwing Designs, hashtag BrassKnucklesMLP.
There's an Ekans in here if anybody don't got one.
You're not throwing that Pokeball.
I'll do it.
So you may be wondering what I, Brass Knuckles, can teach you about assertiveness. Well, I mean, what credibility do I have?
Besides, you know, being a Minotaur and stuff.
That's credibility, right?
Yeah. Takes a lot of hard work.
I don't think they believe us, Ironwell Smith. Mm-hmm. I'm going to have to tell them a story.
Tell them a story.
Get comfortable. Everybody get comfortable. So years ago...
Not that comfortable.
No. Years ago, when I was just a little brass nugget. Years before the reign of Princess Twilight. Gen 1. Represent. Yeah! It was a fun time. It was the 80s. And I loved wearing these fantastic Day-Glow hoof warmers because they were totally in fashion. But one thing that happened while I was wearing these every day is that I was bullied, and not just the bullies.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was bullied in school for what I wore. And let me tell you, Minotaur school is not like pony school where you just sit on your plot all day. Mm-mm. We run.
Hard.
We run hard, and the smell?
Never mind.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
It's not that kind of panel.
It wasn't just you, Ironwell Smith, don't worry. I had a bully in my herd at school with me, and her name was Steel Wool. She rubbed me the wrong way. She was abrasive. She knew my joke, man. And here she is, Steel Wool. Faux leather jacket. Can't have real leather. That'd be cruel, guys. No leather. Mm-hmm. Faux leather jacket, collar up. Thick 80s makeup. So thick. But yet it still couldn't hide that snarl on her face. Brass knuckles, why are you wearing that? Your parents must not be home because they would never let you out like this. Brass knuckles, you're clashing today. And what am I supposed to do? I didn't know how to be assertive then, so I did nothing. I thought, if I ignore it, it'll go away, right? Has any of you ever tried to do that? Does it ever work? No. I didn't know what to do, and so it kept going on. And she kept saying these cruel things. Brass knuckles, you are such a waste of air. I don't know why you bother to breathe. Words like that took my confidence and slowly eroded it. I love what I wore, but I didn't know what to do, and it hurt. It hurt so bad that all of my confidence slowly eroded into a red, hot, seething ball of anger until one day...
Pow, right in the kisser.
I hit her, but it wasn't like that. I didn't know how to fight. I wasn't that kind of aggressive Minotaur like Ironwell Smith. I didn't know what I was doing, and I was so embarrassed, I just pretended it didn't happen. And no pony even stopped. When you see bullying, you have to stop it. The herd didn't even stop running. And so a cloud of bullying started to gather above my head. And it lasted for the rest of my grade school years. And then one day, the best part of being a Minotaur is the day you get the letter like Harry Potter that accepts you into Assertiveness Academy. I had made it to Assertiveness Academy. I could start over. Things would be great. No one would know that I love wearing socks and it was weird. I could be my own pony. Except at Assertiveness Academy, every pony else was not wearing socks. It was weird. I didn't want to be teased or bullied again. So what do you think I did? I threw him away. I so wanted to be accepted by others that I couldn't accept myself. Accept yourself and all of your talents and interests, hobbies and quirks. I didn't, and so that cloud of bullying turned into a dark rain of depression. And I didn't love myself. And I didn't know what to do. It was like a curse had been thrown down on me by an evil queen. This is just a changeling's tie. I mean, it didn't really happen. This is my little tie. They have my little ties too. It's a changeling's, a chrysalis, but it doesn't mean anything, right? Yeah, okay. I did join Queen Chrysalis. I mean, villains have to stick together, right? I didn't love myself. That was the problem. I didn't have love for them to feed on, so why not hang out with them? 10 years with the changelings. Now remember, this was like the 90s and 2000s, so they were cool. But they're just changelings, and they just kind of left me alone. So one day, I went into Ponyville. Now this is the newest generation. Great friendship is magic. I go into Ponyville and my things had changed. The ponies were prettier. And I could hustle some good bits out of them now. And I looked in the window and there was a pair of hoof warmers. And I realized, you know what? I still liked them. I still loved wearing colorful socks and hoof warmers. Please throw those back to me. It was like, why did I ever do that? I still wanted to be my own minotaur. And I loved these. And then suddenly, was that a sonic rainbow? I saw what it was to be myself again, and I learned so much about being assertive after that. And I am going to share with you in the next half hour a few more tips about how to get from being that horrible, sad, lonely, bullied minotaur to being able to stand up and be proud and share assertiveness with you all. So are you ready to learn more about being assertive?
Yeah.
Now I have to say, I'm very happy not to be living with those changelings anymore. Especially...
Yeah, you know, they got beat pretty bad at that royal wedding.
The endangered species now, I'm sorry. I learned that friendship is magic, and I also learned this truth. There is no use in being accepted by others if you don't accept yourself. Accept your interests and talents, weaknesses and strengths, hobbies and quirks. Accept yourself. Now say it with me. Accept yourself. Again.
Accept yourself.
Yes.
That's right.
We all know someone who's dealt with depression, bullying, and self-doubt.
And as bronies, you've probably met someone in person or online. It says bronies are weird, crazy, girly, and not in a good way.
Mm-hmm. We need to show everyone that you can. You have to accept yourself. I learned to be assertive once I accepted myself. And every brony can be assertive. Say it again. You can be assertive. Now, one, two, three. I can be assertive. Now, hoof bump your neighbor again. Do it. I can be assertive.
I can be assertive.
I can be assertive. Today, you'll learn brass knuckles assertiveness skills in the next 40 minutes. We're doing good. You can be awesome like us. You can stand up for yourself, and you can stand up to those bullies. And you can also wear awesome hoof warmers. Yeah, I've seen some fantastic socks at this con, and it makes me so happy.
Ponies with socks.
Ponies with socks. Hey, Iron Will Smith. This is a PG con.
They're palm trees.
We'll do that outside. So, what is assertiveness? What are you here for? We've gone through some cool stories, but what is assertiveness? It's a type of communication that deals with a problem. It's used to defend your space. It's about being firm with your concerns. Say it with me. Be firm with your concerns. It includes both listening to others and accepting what they say while expressing your own feelings, needs, and desires. And we are here to learn those assertive ways. We will teach you how to be assertive. So as I said in my hoof warmer story, you have to accept yourself. Accept that you may not be the best at talking to other ponies. You may have totally embarrassed yourself in the past. Trust me. It happens.
Totally.
Mm-hmm. But don't sweat it. We got some Pegasi in the house. Who's a Pegasus? All right. Have you heard this quote? Don't block the sunshine of life's today with the clouds of life's yesterday.
Smart.
That's right. Get over your fears and doubts. You're better than that. And you know what? We are here to make sure that you are confident in yourself and are ready to attack the day.
And not each other.
Let me hear you say it. Attack the day.
Attack the day.
Again, attack the day.
And for the record, attack the day also does not mean hitting Celestia. That's not cool either.
Fair point. Now the next logical step is to explain about what being assertive is all about. Remember Fluttershy? At one point, Fluttershy was very shy. In fact, shy wasn't even her middle name. It was her first. Right? She got up on stage just like our volunteers have, and she learned to be assertive. I mean, she's always been shy and at some times submissive. So when we talk about the assertiveness spectrum, Fluttershy is at the low end of the assertiveness spectrum. Right, she's so shy, she's hiding behind the line. Sometimes submissives, when they speak, may think they've spoken clearly, but the message didn't get through because they were shy and quiet, no matter the emotion behind it. Saying something like, oh, I don't want to do that, it's not the same as saying, I don't want to. Because they're not firm with their concerns, their message doesn't necessarily get across. You have to be firm with your concerns. Say it again. Be firm with your concerns. And shy ponies just don't do that often. They also tend to not make eye contact. And what did we say about that, Iron Will Smith?
Don't be shy. Look them in the eye.
You got it. When there's something wrong, shy ponies may be knowing about it, but not disclosing. And if something goes wrong and they have to choose between fighting or flight, running away, they'll choose flight. Absolutely. They often have a lack of self-respect for themselves and their needs. And we say assertive deeds meet your needs. Say it with us. Assertive deeds meet your needs. Excellent. And submissive ponies are often in imbalanced relationship, like Fluttershy was with?
Angel. Who said?
Angel.
That's right. And on the other side of the extremity is aggressive. Angel is aggressive, especially when he wants his way with Fluttershy.
Uh-huh.
We haven't converted him yet.
Not yet.
Yeah. Aggressive folks have the instinct to fight instead of flight, move with the intent to hurt others, uh-huh, express feelings, needs, and ideas at the expense of others. They can be abusive, rude, sarcastic, overpowering, and dominating. And not in a fun way either.
Thank you, Iron Will Smith. Assertiveness isn't being submissive, and it's not being aggressive either. Assertiveness is being firm with your concerns without domination. Okay. And it's also being like me. Assertive is making sure that assertive deeds meet your needs. Say it again. Assertive deeds meet your needs. So now that we've gone over these types on the assertiveness spectrum, you could be anywhere on that scale, from a little of one to a lot of one. And we're gonna show you an example to help you out. So imagine that Iron Will Smith and myself are, let's say, in a hotel room, right? Who's staying in the hotel room?
I'm actually not.
Ooh. We're pretending, Iron Will Smith.
I know.
How many of you have noisy neighbors last night? We're gonna use that as our example. So we're gonna pretend that tonight Iron Will Smith had a party room and he is rocking away and you have to get up early in the morning for your first panel and you can't sleep. What do you do about that? You don't have to raise your hands, but think about this. Do you take a deep breath and try and ignore that loud music?
Or do you bang on the wall and let him know that it's too loud?
Or maybe you don't do anything, but in the morning you write a really nice note and slide it under the door.
Or a nasty note.
Mm.
Get good.
Or maybe you get so angry that you march over to the door and bang on it and demand for him to be quiet. Or, you know, when he answers, you could actually explain that while he's being loud, you can't sleep, and that you'd like him to turn down the music so that you can get some sleep for the next day. Which are you? It's a lot of options, but there's only one truly assertive one, where you calmly talk to the other party and explain what needs to be done. Because
assertive deeds meet your needs.
Say it again. Assertive deeds meet your needs. Excellent. When things go wrong and needs aren't addressed, ponies can accumulate enormous amounts of anger. If you're shy, that anger can spill over. Think about me in steel wool. When I got so upset, I went from being really shy to so angry that I actually fought her. Can you think of someone that's gone through an explosion that they may not have been able to control? That happens because in the cycle, you can go from submissive
to aggressive,
back to submissive,
to aggressive,
to submissive.
Oh, and aggressive again.
And back and forth forever, unless you learn to be assertive. You have to be able to balance those needs to be able to express yourself so that you don't blow up at something random that you really didn't mean to, but something just happened. It happens. So you need to get out of that cycle. And I learned to do that by accepting myself. Start now. Save yourself some time. Avoid this cycle by being assertive. And I'm going to share with you right now the keys to assertiveness. It's Brass Knuckles' patented three-part assertiveness technique. It's called the SAFE. Play it safe by doing these three things. Are you ready? Describe the specific act or offending behavior that's making you upset. Explain how it makes you feel. And also describe the effects, impacts, or consequence that it has on you. Brass Knuckles calls this the SAFE method. S-A-F-E, specific act, feeling, and effects. That's all that you need to know to become assertive. I'm serious. It's great. Learning how to interact with others takes time, but by using this method, you too can become a master like us. Now we're going to share a statement that Fluttershy actually used to be assertive. Mm-hmm. So let's give her an example. She's really grown, and in Flutterbrudder, everybody seen Flutterbrudder?
Okay. Yeah.
If not, close your ears. Spoilers. Spoilers. So in Flutterbrudder, when Fluttershy's brother, Zephyr Breeze, moved back into their house, he started trashing their father's cloud collection. And how could he, right? It was cruel.
Terrible.
But Fluttershy had to call out Zephyr on that. Disrespect. She said, Zephyr, can't you see what you're doing?
And Zephyr said, I'm getting rid of his old stuff and turning it into an art studio. That's how we talked, right?
Right? Zephyr trashed their mother's flowers and their father's favorite bits of cloud. Fluttershy was actually assertive in that episode, and she explained that when Zephyr flew in and changed everything that their mom and dad had built over the years, longer than they had been alive, that it hurt their feelings because their parents loved those things. Fluttershy told her parents, I know speaking up for you can be hard, but believe me, Zephyr can never stand on his own if he leans on you.
So the specific act was when he trashed their parents' stuff.
They feel hurt. And the effect is that it hurts both of them because their belongings were thrown out and their son Zephyr couldn't stand on his own without leaning on others. So Fluttershy and her parents both had to be assertive by using a SAFE statement. Crazy.
And for the record, I just have to say, as an adult who lives at home, that episode made me go, what are you trying to say, Larson?
Yeah.
But we can all be independent. It's a balance, right?
It looks that way. So here's some words of wisdom. I highly recommend that if you try to use a SAFE statement, you write it down first. Because I don't have time to go into detail on how to do it. If you want to learn more, please again sign up for my email list that should be going around. And remember to visit me. I'm actually downstairs at booth C8 and askbrassknuckles.tumblr.com. And also hashtag BrassKnucklesMLP if you're posting. Also post pictures of your Pokemon that you've caught. Hashtag BrassKnucklesMLP. I see a cheer in the back, okay? Thank you. So the other way to be safe is to talk about your feelings. Because while bronies tend to love friendship and happiness, there's a lot of people in the real world that get kind of weirded out when you talk about feelings. So that feel can be an awkward situation.
Feels, bro.
Yeah, but you have to be able to explain it. And sometimes it can get so awkward that the other person will actually accept your need because they want to get out of that awkward conversation. That's my secret to assertiveness. Yeah. So now that I've shared with you, it's safe. Again, turn to the brony next to you and say, I can be assertive and hoof bump. I can be assertive. You can be assertive. Yeah. So before I share other secrets that I've learned over the last 10 years with you, I want to have a little bit of time to answer some short, specific questions. We have about 20 minutes left. So if you have short, specific questions about what we've already gone over, our goats will bring you up on stage slowly on the stairs. So raise your hands. We can take two or three questions. We've got one in the front. One over in the back, the gentleman in the Pinkie Pie. Raise your hand up. Don't be sorry. Be assertive. Excellent. Come on up, Pinkie Pie, and they're leaving. One over here. Yep, that one. That one and those two, and that'll be all for now. Yep. And again, I'm in booth C8. If you have other questions, I will be going down afterwards, and you can get amazing brass knuckle swag.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah. All right, so our first question.
Okay, hopefully this is an appropriate question to ask, but how do you get over the feeling that, or excuse me, the fear that you may annoy people? Like, once in a while, I have a fear of doing that, and I guess it ties into me not liking people being mad at me, because when they are, it really gnaws at me until, like, it's all resolved.
So the question is, what can you do to make people understand that you're not trying to ignore them?
Not
annoy.
Oh, annoy them. Sorry. Okay. Okay, you want to answer that?
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Believe it or not, I actually struggle with that a lot. I'm very self-conscious. And really, the worst thing that can happen is they just tell you no, or they just tell you, hey, this is a private conversation. It's not nearly as big a deal as many people think it is. So just put yourself out there, man. It's easy. Just make yourself the coolest person in the world. That's what I do. Think of yourself as the coolest person in the world. They want to talk to me.
And also, when you want to talk to people, ask them if you can join them, if it's a group that you're stepping into. And actually, we were going to get into that later, but I think we've got some tips we can share right now. Let's see. Because I know you were going to do this. Page 17. Yeah. So when you're talking to other people and you want to join a group, to be honest, there's a lot of ways that you can do it, and some people may say no, they don't want to hang out with you, but if you think that might be annoying, make sure that you are able to ask to join, and then Iron Will Smith has a little tip here.
Oh, yeah. Talk about them, not yourself. Compliments are a great way to break the ice, dude.
So sometimes you can find someone annoying if they only talk about themselves, right? So make compliments about someone else and let them talk, and they'll probably think that you're not so annoying because you're actually complimenting them. People like to hear that, right?
People like compliments.
Yeah. So make sure to ask to join a group and then also start to allow them to talk and make sure you don't dominate the conversation. Thank you. Let's hear it for our first question. Okay, we'll go over here.
Oh, okay.
We'll take turns. All right, and your name?
Vito.
Okay, this is Vito. Question.
Yes. How do you communicate to someone or another party that don't care about your feelings or how it affects you? Mm-hmm. Like, for example, with the, I guess you could say noisy neighbors or whatever. Mm-hmm. You go there, you knock, say, hey, I got to get up in the morning. Say, hey, man, go play with some pizza
right?
or something.
What? This is not a real example, is it?
Well, I'm trying to keep it G-rated. So.
Thank you. So what do you do? What do you do when they don't listen to you and you do the safe statement?
Yeah.
So that is actually an advanced technique that we won't have time to go into, but I'll tell you what to look up. And it's called reflective listening. And what it has to do with is listening to others. We'll mention it again at the end, but when they're saying things back to you, one of our secret tips is on page 19. Look at this, I knew you guys would answer these questions. So you don't want to make assumptions about them because they're probably just reacting. They're not thinking about you at all. They're thinking about themselves. And a lot of times we want to do reflective listening to be able to tell them what they're telling us because they may not understand that that's a mean thing to say, offensive, or maybe you don't like pizza. So do we have some Mod Pie fans in the house? Who here's gotten Ingrid's autograph already? A couple. All right. So she's here, and we love her, and actually she's doing yoga now, and I really wish that I could do that. But, you know, we're glad you're all here. So here's a great way to remember how to do reflective listening and to look it up online later, or see me at booth C8. I'll be there tonight and tomorrow. It is being able to think about what the person said. So if he said, go away and eat pizza, then listen and say, did you mean to say that you don't care about me and you want me to do that? And then they say, oh, absolutely. And you say, well, when you say that, I feel embarrassed because I don't think that's appropriate and you're being loud and I need to sleep. So you would keep repeating the safe process with the addition of reflective listening. We like to say, listen to observe, not reply.
Like Mod Pie.
Listen to observe, not reply, like Mod Pie. Here, you can have this back. And think, observe, what would Maud do? She would listen. She would reflect. Then she would say what it means, but not immediately. Don't take things to heart, because oftentimes they're not thinking about your heart at all. They're not thinking about the feelings. So you have to be able to tell them that they're not thinking about your feelings. Try that. There are other options as well, but again, we're not trained professionals. So I hope that helps. Take everything with a grain of salt.
Rock salt.
Because you want to listen to observe, not reply, like
Mod Pop.
See? All right, let's hear it for our question. Thank you. Okay.
Thanks, dude.
You take the stairs. So, over there.
What do you do when the person you're trying to be assertive to is family?
Mm-hmm. Very tough. Very tough. You got it. Go for it, Iron Will Smith.
Okay, so if they're your family, you guys are going to see each other all the time, mm-hmm. or sometimes, exactly. You're not only going to see them once. An important thing is mutual respect. So if I respect you, I'm going to give you some leeway to respect me back and forth. It's not going to happen immediately, but it's like building a small, like a sandcastle. You got to build it up over time. Mm-hmm. Not everyone is like an iron fortress.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, thank you.
If you had any.
Yeah, we can help you more afterwards, yeah. Definitely. Look for us.
Yeah, totally.
Thank you very much. All right. And your name?
Hi, I'm Mel.
Okay, and your question?
I work with kids, and some of them can be very angry when you need to tell them no.
Yes.
Sometimes, you know, I'm a gentle sort of person. I sit down and I talk to them and I ask them what their feelings are. But if he's still approaching the electrical outlet,
yes.
I need to do something.
Stay safe.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is there any way that I can do that other than picking him up and taking him away?
Mm-hmm. That's a tough one. Well, you got anything? Mm. I can try.
Okay, so I have multiple younger siblings. And, well, I don't know if I should say this because it's not good, but I use guilt. Kids are way more simple than they let on to be. Really, they just want attention. Mm-hmm. They want attention. They want to be recognized.
There's probably a few kids in here that still want that.
Me.
Mm-hmm. You can say more. That's all I have. Yeah, and I also think that a lot of times it is more difficult with children, and sometimes explaining the lesson doesn't work, so I would say the other thing to do is to be able to actually have an example, vivid examples, whether it's a picture of a cat that got electrocuted by walking through a wet puddle or something like that. I mean, obviously you don't want to show a dead cat, but find something that they can remember that's not traumatic as an example so they don't have to live through that horrible lesson. It's like you don't want to cross a train track and then show a picture of a vehicle that got hit by a train and the people survived. Something like that for the problems is what we'd recommend to start.
Thank you very
But no means no, right?
Yeah.
All right, thank you. And
we did it!
Yay!
Thanks, everybody who came up.
So we now have exactly 15 minutes left, so we can share one more lesson with you all.
Oh, this one's mine. Oops.
Interacting with others, page 12. All right, so are you ready for one final lesson before we finish?
Yeah.
Now, what did I say earlier? Every brony can be assertive, right? 15, sorry. Every brony can be assertive. So we're going to share with you some secrets for standing up to yourself with that personal space respect that we talked about. So once you're able to use a safe statement to interact with others, you also, to talk to others. So you're going to be safe, talk to others. But that interaction, as we mentioned with some of the questions, can be a little awkward. So here's how you can interact with others. Assertiveness, again, is a type of communication used to deal with a problem, to defend your space. It's being firm with your concerns. Say it again, be firm with your concerns. So as you're being firm, you're gonna have to deal with those problems and defend your space. So we're gonna have a volunteer come up to help us to show that personal space issue. Okay, goats. Who are they gonna choose this time? All right, we have a volunteer. Come on down. Yay, let's get a round of applause.
I was gonna try to clap in a circle as a visual pun. Round of applause.
Oh.
I'm terrible, you can beat me up after the show.
Come on up. Again, no physical violence. Be assertive and tell him how punny he is.
Tell me how bad my jokes are, please.
Come on up. And stand right here. Stand right here. Yep. And your name is Lauren?
No.
What?
Beck.
This is Beck? Mm-hmm. Okay, this is Beck. So, Beck, Iron Wolf Smith and I are going to get really close. How do you feel?
Not good.
What right? is going on when we are this close?
I'm telling you a secret or something.
Don't you wish? All right, guys, give her some space. So what happened here is that we got into your personal space. I'm real supposed to step a little further out, okay? So if we are actually trying to deal with this comfort bubble that other people have, it may be an aura, comfort zone, or a boundary. So when we're this far, you feel better? Have you guys ever experienced that?
Yes.
All right, so let's get a round of applause. Thank you for letting us get in your personal space. Thanks so much. Let's get another volunteer. One more volunteer. So what that comfort bubble is going to exist for every pony. And one of the things that we actually like to say is to respect that boundary. Iron Will Smith, what do we like to say?
To be an assertiveness ace, respect their personal space.
Ooh.
I've been doing this for years. You think I'd remember?
Yeah. So to be an assertiveness ace.
Respect.
Try it again. To be an assertiveness ace.
Respect their personal space.
Right on. So what we're going to do now is disrespect the personal space of our volunteer. What's your name?
Ashley.
Okay. Iron Will Smith, I'll take your clipboard.
Oh, whoops.
Okay. So come back over here. Now what's going to happen is Iron Will Smith is going to approach you. And when he does, let him know when it starts to get uncomfortable. So slowly walk forward towards Ash Pony. Slow, slow.
That's enough.
Okay, that's enough. Ashley, raise your hand up and point towards him. Okay, Iron Will Smith, raise your hand up and point towards Ash. Do you see how that's a little bit longer than about one arm's length? That is the personal space of both of them. So you actually did a great job because you are defending your space. It's a little awkward, right?
Mm-hmm. I know my space.
But you get a keychain. Thank you. Let's hear it for Ashley.
I haven't been on MySpace in years.
Oh. To be an assertiveness ace, respect their personal space. Now you got your good line here. Right there.
Respect their personal space. Don't get in their face.
Uh-huh. Respect yourself, respect others, and respect Iron Will Smith's fists. Again.
To be an assertiveness ace, respect their personal space.
You got it. And one other note. Sometimes you need to ask permission to hug other ponies. Okay, I'm hearing some nods and some mm-hmm sisters. Please ask before, because they may have a very good reason for you not to want to hug, whether it's a medical issue, a just feeling weird issue, or they just don't like to hug strangers. So always say, "I'm Real Smith, can I hug you?" Oh, yay. So I would say hug somebody next to you, but let's just instead say every pony can be assertive. And hoof bump your neighbor again.
Don't leave me hanging.
Yeah, I can be assertive. I can be assertive, that's right. And that's all that happens. So we have time for one last volunteer to help us out before we finish. We're going to favorite princess.
Okay.
Because a personal space isn't just about how close I like to get to Iron Will Smith, because we are buddy, 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 but it also includes appropriate emotional distance as well. Hello, please stand between us. What is your name?
Name's Chris.
This is Chris, everybody. Our example of emotional distance that you need to respect is going to be favorite princess.
Yeah. Everyone likes this subject, right? Yeah.
So, Iron Will Smith, who is best princess?
Luna, of course, right?
Luna? Chris, who actually is best princess?
Twilight!
Oh, bro. Luna's the best.
No. Who is right?
Twilight is.
Okay. All right. I'm gonna get in here. So both of them think that there are different best princesses. We all have our own beliefs. So what happens when this goes on?
It escalates.
It escalates, and other people will get into the argument.
Yeah.
It gets personal. So on the count of three, I want you to yell out your favorite princess's name. One, two, three. What was that?
Kate.
Oh, so every pony has their own favorite princess. Every pony has their own beliefs. Every pony has the right to those beliefs, and that's mental, personal space. So what happens is every social media argument in the history of the internet has been caused by these beliefs because we don't respect their personal space because to be an assertiveness ace.
Respect their personal space. You got it.
I challenge you, the next time you see an argument, to take a step back. Respect that other person's position. And by respecting their values and not just saying that they are wrong, you hold in your hands a key to assertiveness.
Respect it.
Chris, thank you. Best princess is still best princess. Now I know what you're thinking. You say it's easy, brass knuckles, but it's not. I can't do this. You can! You can be assertive. Every brony can be assertive. So we're gonna go through our last couple tips and then we're gonna share the last most important one with you. So be true, don't assume, because sometimes people will assume that you're doing something to be mean, but they may just need to talk. So ask questions if you're not sure why they're doing something mean. Oh, what was this? Listen to observe, not reply.
Hey! You're listening.
Reflective listening. Taking everything with a grain of?
Rock salt. Hey.
You got it. Every brony can be assertive. Do you feel like you can interact better with others?
Great.
It's a start. I guarantee you, if you start to practice these tips, with that in mind, you will be successful. And if you're not
100% satisfied, you pay nothing. Yeah, I like it.
I learned from all our volunteers today that every brony can be assertive. One more time. Say, I can be assertive and hoof bump. I can be assertive. I can be assertive. Yeah.
Yeah.
We need a couple more hoof bumps. We need a couple more hoof bumps.
We don't
all
need
right.
nobody hanging in here.
At the very least, by now, you should have learned the following assertiveness phrases. Are you ready for the whirlwind tour of assertiveness?
Yes!
No means?
No.
Accept?
Yourself.
Be firm.
With your concerns.
Assertive deeds.
Meet your needs.
To be an assertiveness ace?
Respect their personal space.
Be true, don't assume. Listen to observe, not reply, like my pie. And use these to play it safe, which is specific act, feeling, and effects.
Hey, he remembered.
He's so good, Chris is awesome.
Chris but is like our biggest fan.
Chris is awesome, and you know what? You can be as awesome as Chris, too, if you practice using our assertiveness techniques.
And you get the shoes. You got to get the shoes.
Don't you pity the foal who didn't attend today?
Yeah. I challenge you, all of you, attack the day.
Attack the day.
And I mean it, guys. Don't go hitting Celestias. That's not okay.
Me too. I challenge you to apply what you learned. It's not everything, but it's a start. Again, I wish we had all day here, but our time is short and those guys in the back are cheering us on to finish on time. It's impossible to share everything now, so again, I am downstairs in C8 if you want to come to my booth. I am at askbrassknuckles.tumblr.com. And again, don't be afraid to ask help from friends or counselors too, because it's a team effort. So as you prepare to go out the doors like this gentleman right here, ooh, he's not going out the doors.
Never mind.
As you prepare to go out the doors behind you, remember to have an iron will. You can do it. Every brony can be assertive, and so can you. Now get out there and attack the day.
Let's have a good day, everybody. We hope you enjoyed it.